Hey guys, and welcome to My Sims 4 Cats and Dogs Let's Play. So, I guess we'll just get straight into this because I'm already late. Like, this Let's Play was supposed to be like when the pack was released, literally. So, I'm like well overdue. So, let's not waste any more time and let's just get straight into it and let me introduce you to the family. So, first, let's start with the oldest, which is our main, I guess, protagonist, whatever you want to call her. She is a single mom, obviously. There's not too many Sims, so don't. It's not going to be overwhelming. It's a pretty simple story, but I really like it. I think it's really cute. But yeah, she's a single mom. I'll let me get up her little thing so you can see, you know, just her traits and stuff. I'll do that for everyone. So she is a single mom. I've said that for the third time now. And she when she was in a relationship with, you know, the guy, the baby daddy, forgot her name, Adeline. Yeah, I get names mixed up all the time. I'm really bad. So she was with him, and that's when they got this dog. They got the dog together because, you know, they were together and they were like, let's get a dog and he's cute and stuff. And his name's Neo, by the way. I'm like hovering over the names because I don't know them. I do, but I made them, obviously. But anyways, let's not waste any time. So they got Neo, and they literally were like in love, whatever. And she got pregnant, obviously, with Adeline. And he was cheating, and then she was like, you know what, bitch, I'm leaving and I'm taking your motherfucking dog. Well, they bought the dog together, so it wasn't really like anyone's, but he really liked the dog. But she was like, bitch, I'm taking the motherfucking dog because you've just cheated on me and that's like disgusting and I'm pregnant. And, you know, so she shipped out with Adeline, and she bought this house. So yeah, so it was pretty cheap. Like, it wasn't too expensive. It was pretty affordable at the time. And she was like, this is a really good deal, and it's a really nice place, and I can raise Adeline. And, you know, it seems this Brindleton Bay seems like quite a nice area. So she was like, this is perfect, I'm gonna snap this up. And she has the qualifications to be a veterinarian, and she's always wanted to do it, but she's obviously hadn't had the money. But she was kind of thinking that, you know, maybe I can do a little business, even if... So basically, she started off doing a, like, haircuts and cutting dog owners' hair and cat owners' nails, and... No, not the cat owners' nails, the cat's nails, dog nails... cutting hair, washing, you know, that sort of stuff, because obviously she hadn't, like, I don't know if you need a permit or, you know, something to be a vet, like, legally or whatever, but she didn't have that. She didn't have the money to, like, get any of the equipment, so she was starting out just doing, like, pampering stuff for dogs and cats, and it's not really what she wanted to do, but she was getting there. It was kind of like a slow build, and she didn't have the money to, like, do the big stuff, so... She slowly started building up her business and doing that, and she slowly started to make more money, and so she was enjoying that for a little while. She did that for, and she was raising Adeline at the same time, so it was quite, and she was like a little baby, so it was quite hard. So she's a trooper, just letting you guys know. But then there's a new clinic that's just dropped in town recently, and, you know, it's not helping the business, because, you know, they're this, like, big company, and she's like, fuck, and they're down the road as well. Like, she's in the corner on the street, they're, like, in central, well, almost central, you know, town, so it's not really looking good, you know, but it's her dream, you know, and she's only just started. Wait, that's the basement. There's nothing in there, by the way. Look, it's just boxes, you know, with the resources and stuff, you know, needed to run a clinic. But she's only recently just started getting the equipment for, like, doing proper, like, stuff, like diagnosing, and, you know, and then they go open theirs, and they've got, like, all the big machines, and she's like, fuck, like, this is like the worst thing that could happen in this situation. So yeah, that's kind of her story, and obviously kind of, I guess, Adeline's story as well. Her name, I didn't say her name. Her name's Ada, cute name, I know. But yeah, I can't believe I didn't say the name in the beginning, but you know now. So I think I've got this written down, so that's why I'm kind of like umming and ahhing, because I'm reading it and trying to work out if I missed anything. I literally just wrote this down like 10 minutes before recording this, so it's a little jumbled. And then let's talk about the pet. So you met Neo, he's cute as fuck. Oh yeah, you do want to know that? Oh, I thought I could show you the traits of the dogs and stuff, but you can't see the dogs. I think that was a real big oversight, not being able to even see the kind of panel, the simology panel of the dogs and cats, because like we don't even know them, you know. So, and I can't show you, so it's a little bit annoying. But they're pretty good pets. But Cosmo is, I've got a little story for Cosmo. But she, Neo's a he, Cosmo's a she. The name's kind of mixed up. It was supposed to be called Nia. I don't know. I changed that last minute, obviously. I'm like literally just figuring out shit on the spot. Anyways, Cosmo is, it looks kind of similar to my cat that died, my cat Smudge. If you go on my Twitter, you'll see her right pop up. She's pinned, and I don't want to move her from my pinned tweet. She's going to be my pinned tweet on Twitter forever, literally. But you can see her if you go, it's in the link, but there'll be a link below to my Twitter and you'll see her there. If you want to, you don't have to. But she's kind of, I'm paying homage to my cat that died later this year. Earlier this year. I'm not even making sense. And because she was a black cat. That's literally the only similarities. But anyways, Cosmo, I just thought that, you know, it'd be cute to kind of have a black cat because I don't have one anymore. This isn't a history lesson about my life. I'm wasting so much time rambling. Cosmo is a stray cat, well, was a stray cat, that Adeline found when they were out at the beach or something. And she was like, can we keep her? And then she was like, we've already got a dog and, you know, the business isn't thriving. So, but then she just was like, you know what, it's a cat, you know, you literally don't even need to look after cats that much, like they literally do their own thing, just eat shit and it's fine, I guess we can. And she'll make Adeline really happy as well, so she was like, okay, you can take her home. But basically she wanted to call her Lucky, Adeline the toddler, she wanted to call her Lucky. But Ada was kind of like, should we call her Cosmo? Because Adeline was like, I want to name her Lucky because it was lucky that we found her and stuff. She's quite intelligent. She's quite a bright baby, if I guess that's the word, bright baby, bright toddler. She's quite intelligent. So she was like, you know, it's lucky that we found her, so I want to name her Lucky because it's like has meaning. But then Ada was like, should we name her Cosmo? Because Cosmo is like a word relating to the universe. I searched it. It came up with something to do with the universe. And I was like, you know, the universe kind of makes things happen. And like, it's kind of a god to some people. Some people believe in God and some other people believe in the universe. And, you know, my mom does. She talks about it all the time. But then I guess Ada told Adeline about the kind of universe and, you know, it bringing people together, making things happen. And so it was kind of the same thing as Lucky, like it's lucky that we found her. But then Ada was kind of like, the universe made this happen kind of thing. So I hope that makes sense. It was a little cute story behind Cosmo. But yeah, she's cute as fuck, like look how small she is. But yeah, that's the story. I think that's literally it. I hope I went over everything I could, and hopefully that wasn't too long, because I felt like I was rambling for like 5 hours then. But this is the clinic. It's kind of it's not super sophisticated. It is a house. This house, by the way, is by Andrew Arcade. If you watch him, it's probably looking quite familiar to you because it is. He did build it recently, and I'll link his channel and stuff in the description if you want to go visit him. You're probably already watching him though, because he's quite he's established. He's an established channel, so. Yeah, I really love this house though, and I've kind of converted it into a house slash clinic, and the basement, like you saw below. Then we've got this floor with the magazines and the little waiting area. This is also the main waiting area. This is the main room, and then the toilet, very basic, and then we've got the main where the magic happens. This is where she was doing washing and bathing, and now it's actually turned into an examination room in where she can actually do stuff. So she's actually doing more now. Like I said, she's she's actually a vet now, but she doesn't do all the stuff that the sophisticated big vet over here does. They do everything, but she's not yet there yet because she can't fit it in. Like, she can't fit in the stuff, and she hasn't got the money as well. So yeah, I hope you guys like the family already. I love them. They're so cute. Like, I just think this kind of, I just love, why is it outside? I want to get it inside. I've only just started the game, so. But yeah, she's got the cat bed in her room because obviously she was the, can we call the cat over? No, the mother can't. But obviously we're living on the vet lot, so we're living on our business lot. So I don't know if that's going to cause problems with the toddler, because the toddler's grayed out and you can send it to daycare. So that's actually quite handy because we can save it. We can ask the daycare to look after her if something's going on, and we can do that like on command. Instead of just having to go out, we can actually just stay here and have her go to the daycare. So it's actually pretty cool. I like that. But this is her room, very cute. This is the mom's room. Again, very, it's a very basic small apartment. This is a old bathroom that hasn't really been done. It's kind of just, it's, she wants to get it done because it's her ensuite, but she hasn't really got the money to do it, and it's got a toilet and a sink, so she's just left it for now. But she doesn't really use it because it's not that nice. And then this is the kitchen with the food bowls down here, a little stool randomly there. So it's quite shabby, but it's also quite homey. I really like it, and I love the fact, oh, this is the main bathroom. So it's basically a three bathroom house, which is quite cool. But I think let's open up the vet, like, straight away. Like, let's not waste any more time. This Let's Play is already, like, how late, you know? So let's, I don't actually know how to do it, honestly. I should have researched this, before. Oh, here we go. So let's just open, girl. It's open all hours. That's basically the story. She's got a 24-hour running vet clinic. So, and that's kind of what she has over them. They shut, you know, after hours, but she's, because she lives here, she can be here all hours. But it is a little bit taxing on the family. Like, the toddler kind of wakes up when people are knocking on the door, and, you know, it gets quite busy. It doesn't get that busy because she's not, like, very popular, but it does get busy sometimes. So, are you here for something? Are you guys here? Nope. Okay, so if you want to, like, ask any questions, like, about them, like, the Sims, you can feel free. Like, you don't... I will be happy to answer anything. I like to flesh them out more with questions and stuff, so it's fine. You can ask any questions you want. I love it. I love questions. So... we actually haven't got that many toys for her, but that's the thing. It's cramped up here. She hasn't been able to buy, like, loads of things for her daughter. So it's kind of... and she's struggling. She doesn't want to lose the house. She feels like she's going to lose the house. And because the clinic next door has just moved in recently, she's like, shit, the money is just going down. Like, it's just going to... The cat's still not in the house. Is it blocked off? Can it not go upstairs? Is that the thing? I wonder if that's the thing. Oh, we've got our first customer. Can we just pick up the cat, though, please? Because we need to get inside. Oh, see, this is the... I haven't done the vet clinic yet, so I don't know. But I didn't know that was the check-in thing. I thought that was for her to, like, examine the cat. The cats and dogs. So, put Cosmo down here. Put it down here. What the hell? We're losing our customer. Okay, so let's greet. Greet patient. Let's just do that straight away. How you doing, girl? So, Bartholomew. Nice name. Long but nice. I like it. Or is it Bartholomew A? Has been looking a bit sickly lately. Can you examine him? Sure thing, girl. Just wait in here and we'll bring him to you when he's done. Oh, the outfit is banging. I didn't even remember to customize outfits, but I like this outfit. Okay, get on the thing, you little beauty. I'm so excited that I'm finally recording, because I haven't been able to record because I just haven't been feeling... I've been feeling really excuse me. This isn't your room. We might have to lock the door because we don't want to be interrupted, but I do want the families to sit in the room if they want to. So I don't want to lock it to everyone, but I will lock it just to the pets. No, just these pets, because obviously everyone else's pets can come in. Anyways, yeah, I haven't been recording this. I've been putting this Let's Play on hiatus. Well, it hasn't started, but I've been putting it off because I've just been really tired. But I'm feeling good now, so let's do this. I'm really excited. Treatment. So this is basically just like get to work. Can we check his nose? Because that's what I'm seeing is... looking quite... Check temperature, because it might be quite hot, because it's red. It's got a red nose, you know? Treatment. Oh, no, we need to... Okay, we just need to exam loads of things, I guess. Exam mouth. Listen to breathing, because it's nose. I can see that that's what's looking... Oh, there we go. Here we go, up the top. Check chart. Oh, it's steaming. Ooh, girl. Oh my gosh. This is looking quite severe. But she knows what she's doing. She's been doing this for she's been a certified vet for quite a while now. She's distraught. Look at her. What does it say? The wait times here were short and sweet. Oh, thank you. Thank you. But if you're wondering why it's one star, it's obviously because we just started. But she has been going down lately because of the other... Oh, treatment. What do we treat her with? Winterfest fever. Okay. Oh, is that like a little hint to like seasons, like Winterfest? I wonder if it is. Where's that? Where's Winterfest? Excuse me. Let's calm the pet as well while we're at it, but I don't know. Treatment, cone of shame. Oh, here we go. I'm like literally, my brain's going blank. Like, the cat's so cute. I love it. But yeah, if anything doesn't make sense, like ask questions about the story, because... I literally have just... Oh, yay, we did it! Please rate us 5 stars, please. Can we, like... Oh, is she going? Is that it? I wanted to, like, chat to her and make her feel, like, good. What? Is she going on again? Okay. Is there something else wrong? Okay, there's something else wrong, I guess. Oh, end exam. Oh, I'm an idiot. See, this is really, are you good? Don't leave without your. Okay. I'm guessing the cat will find you. I hope. Yeah. I was like, are we gonna have another pet? Like another? I wouldn't mind, but Ada over here, I think she definitely would. But she's on a lunch break. Oh, this is so cute. I love this kind of dynamic, like the living above a vet and it open 24/7. It's just really interesting. And she's a full-time mother, like, and obviously she doesn't want to take her daughter to daycare too much because it's going to cost money and they don't really have the money. But we didn't, did we gain any money from that? Vet clinic. Oh, this is, yeah, okay, we gained a little bit of money from that. But as you can see, we don't have a lot of money. Like, they have a little bit of backup money, but it's still looking very scarce on the money side. So I hope you guys have enjoyed. I don't know if I should end it now. Like, I feel like just as an introduction, I feel like maybe it should just be short. So I don't know if I should end it. Oh, we got another pet. Okay, we'll do one last pet and then we'll end it then. How you doing, sir? Can we say hi? Excuse me. This is the private area of the. Okay. I guess when we're upstairs, they'll come upstairs. Sir, you just need to check in downstairs, and I'll be with you shortly. You don't need to come upstairs. I'm not sure what is going on with Budge. Cute name. These names are cute, but it's not good. Do you think you could help? Sure thing, sir. Just wait downstairs, and then I'll be right with you. Oh my gosh, why is he upstairs? Should we lock this door? But this is the toilet, you know. Okay, you know what? We're not one of those people that's like we kind of are that family business, you know, when you can kind of do go upstairs and, you know, chat with the family, and it's a relaxed kind of clinic. Like, it's a house, so it's quite informal, and you know, you got the couches, and it's very just like casual, this clinic. So that's also another thing that she's got going for it. Oh, we've leveled up. But yeah, so that clinic's very, you know, done by the book. We let them upstairs, we make them food, you know, we can do whatever. So we're really, it's really a friendly atmosphere in this clinic. So we got derpy doggy syndrome, so let's treat you. It's too stressed. I'm so sorry, sir. I really, oh my gosh, she didn't mean to stress out your dog. Oh god, we need to get that 5 stars. So basically, I guess the goal for this let's play is getting 5 stars so we can beat the clinic over there, because they're probably already at like 3-4 stars. So but we may go over there when we have a problem. I don't know, can we treat our own dogs? I wonder if we can treat our own cat and dog, so we don't have to spend money over there. But if we do end up having to use their facilities, we'll see what their kind of we'll see what their facilities are like, because we haven't been over there because it's a recent clinic and she doesn't want to go over there. Like, she's gonna get really depressed. Bill owner, there we go. The vet was amazing trip. Oh, amazing trip to the vet. Thank you, sir. You're so sweet. Yeah, so I'm gonna end it now. Oh, she's tired. Go to bed, hun. You know what? Put her to bed. Put her to bed. So when she goes to bed, I'm gonna end it then, because I think that's a cute little way to end it. So yeah, I hope you guys love this family, and I try to make it different from everyone else's by doing the vet, the home and vet place together, like in one house, and to live in a different house from the regular lots that everyone lives in and stuff. So I hope that I have made it different, but yeah. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this let's play, and I hope you guys will stay for the whole thing. It'll be really nice to for everyone to follow this family, because I love them. I actually think this is going to be the start of something real good. So anyways, I will see you in the next part. Bye, guys.